Question number 66. An organic compound contained carbon, hydrogen and oxygen gave the following analysis. Carbon 40%, oxygen 53.33%. Its molecular formula may be. Student, first of all, here carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are present. Also, the percentage of carbon is 40%, the percentage of oxygen is 53.33% and the percentage of hydrogen is 6.67%. You can calculate by subtracting the given percentages of carbon and oxygen from 100. Now, students, we know the molar mass of carbon, which is 12, the molar mass of hydrogen is 1 and the molar mass of oxygen is 16. By dividing, we get number of moles of carbon, 40 divided by 12, which is equals to 3.33. Then 6.67 divided by 1 is equals to 6.67. Then here 53.33 divided by 16 is equals to 3.33. Finding out in whole numbers, it will be 1, it will be 2, it will be 1. That means the empirical formula is C1H2O1. Or the molecular formula possible among the given options is C2H4O2. That means the correct answer is option number 1. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 67. Let's read the question. The number of moles of nitrogen in 1 liter of air containing 79% nitrogen by volume under standard conditions is. Students, for this question we need to know that volume of N2 is equals to 1 multiplied by 79 upon 100 liter. That means moles of N2 is equals to 79 upon 100 upon 22.4 liter, since we know that the volume of 1 mole of a gas at STP is 22.4 liter, which is equals to 79 upon 2.24 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 1. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 68. Let's read the question. An element X has the following isotopic composition. X molar mass 100, percentage 80, and X with molar mass 102, percentage 20%. The weighted average atomic mass for the naturally occurring element X is closest to. Students, we know that the formula to calculate average atomic mass is equals to M1 X1 plus M2 X2 upon X1 plus X2. Here the M1 is 100, X1 is 80, M2 is 102, X2 is 20 and X1 plus X2 is 100, which is ultimately equals to 100.4 U. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 2. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 69. Let's read the question. Volume of CO2 obtained at STP by the complete decomposition of 10 gram of limestone, 90% pure, is nearly. Student, first of all, here we are given the decomposition of limestone, which is CaCO3. On decomposition, it gives CaO plus CO2. If this is 100 gram, which is the molar mass of calcium carbonate, 22.4 liter of CO2 at STP is produced. Here we are given with 10 grams. So 10 gram of CaCO3 will form 22.4 divided by 100 multiplied by 10, which is equals to 2.24 liter of CO2. Students, but here it is given as 90% pure. That means the volume of CO2 obtained is equals to 0.9 multiplied by 2.24, which is equals to 2 liter. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 3. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 70. Let's read the question. Select the isosters pair among the following. Students, for this question, first of all, we have to understand isosters. Isoster species have same number of atoms and same number of total electrons. Among the given options, only in case of option number 2, CO and N2, are isosters. Since Cu and N2 both have two atoms each, also the total number of electrons in Cu and N2 is equals to 14. That means option number 2 is the correct answer. Moving to next.